Hola, caracoles! Today's video is all about the plural in Spanish. Basically, there are four rules to create the plural version of a word, which I, Cory, your favorite spring Spanish teacher, will give you today. Pero, if you want to always get the plural right in a conversation while speaking, no quiero que las aprendas de memoria. We are going to take a different approach that will help you bypass these rules. So you don't even have to think about them while speaking Spanish. You just need to pay attention to the word terminations. Like I'll show you now. ¡Comencemos! Regla número uno. Agrega una S al final de la palabra. Here's the complicated rule. If a singular noun ends in a vocal sin acento, A, E, I, O, U, or the stressed vowels, A, E, or O, then the rule is agrega una S to the end of the word to make it plural. That sounds like a textbook, ¿verdad? Pero es fácil. Let's see some examples. Las casas de allá son bonitas. México tiene muchos habitantes. Los dulces me gustan mucho. And that's the trick. You won't be able to remember the rules anyway when you are under the pressure of an actual conversation. So you are better off listening to or reading tons of examples where Spanish native speakers are using the plural correctly. That way, your brain and ears get used to seeing and hearing them correctly. If you then memorize such examples in chunks, your brain will start doing it correctly automatically. So, for the rest of this video, pay most attention to the actual examples and memorize this. If you'd like some help with that, we've created flashcard decks for the chunks from this video and all our other videos for all members of the Spring Spanish Inner Circle. Interested in trying it out? Check the link in the description. Regla número 2. Agrega una S o ESS al final de la palabra. If a singular noun ends in E or U, quiere decir con acento, you can add S or S, ES, to pluralize the word. Puedes o no usar la terminación ES y US, but it sounds fancy. Pay attention to the examples. Los israelíes son de Israel. Los jabalíes son considerados una plaga porque destruyen las granjas. Bambúes también son llamados bambús. Regla número 3. Para los sustantivos que terminan en consonantes. Now, done with vowels. Siguiente. Let's learn about words that end in una consonante. If a singular noun ends in a vowel plus Y or Y, or the consonants L, R, N, T, Z, J, S, X, or Ch, you add an S. Por ejemplo, los reyes de España visitarán México. Yo tengo un video acerca de los meses en español. Las luces de la casa están fundidas. Junk alert! The other day I learned through experience that it's a good idea to learn the term foco fundido. La luz de mi comedor se fundió and I hurt my pinky toe because there was no light. It was super painful. And when I tried to tell this sad story to English speakers, I realized that there is not really a specific word for fundir, although some people use blown for that. So, next time something sad happens to you, you know what to blame. El foco fundido. Oh, and nota importante, if a singular noun ends in Z, you must change the Z to a C before adding S. Actriz, actrices. Eficaz, eficaces. Juez, jueces. Regla número 4. Sustantivos que terminan en un grupo de consonantes. If a singular noun ends in a consonant cluster, more than one consonant at the end of the word, o una vocal plus a consonant other than the mentioned before, adivina qué, solo agrega una S. Los icebergs son mucho más grandes dentro del agua. Los mamuts están extintos. Uno de los cracks del fútbol argentino es Maradona. Time for a quiz. Alright. Now it's time to test your skills. A quiz for you to fill in the plurals. México tiene muchos blank habitantes. Los blank son de Israel. Israelíes. Yo tengo un video acerca de los blank en español. Meses. Las blank de la casa están fundidas. Luces. Los blank están extintos. Mamuts. How many did you get right? Tell me in the comments. Oh, and by the way, now we are in quiz mode, so I have 10 more questions for you to test your Spanish. Click on the image that just appeared around here and let's see how many of these questions in Spanish you will get right. Gracias totales. Adiós.